Kerala Bishop Mar Joseph Kalarangta and the row behind his love and narcotic jihad theory. Speaking at a church in Kottayam district, the bishop raised the twin issue of love jihad and narcotic jihad as grave threats to young men and women of Christian and other non-Muslim faiths. Mar Joseph Kalarangta, Bishop of Palai Diocese of the Siro Malabar Church in Kerala, triggered a major controversy on September 10 when he claimed the existence of narcotic jihad in the state targeting young people belonging to non-Muslim faiths. He also alleged that young women belonging to Christianity and other non-Muslim faiths were being lured by jihadists through love jihad and subjected to exploitation, forced religious conversion and terrorist activities. Who is Mar Joseph Kalarangta? Mar Joseph Kalarangta heads the Palai Diocese of the Siro Malabar Church, one of the biggest Catholic churches in the state. The diocese is home to the largest concentration of Siro Malabar Christians in Kerala. Kalarangta, born in 1956 and ordained as a priest in 1982, is considered a scholar and authority on topics of theology within the church. He has authored over 30 books. He is currently the chairman of Siro Malabar Synodal Commission for Family, Laity and Life and yields enormous clout within the church. What did the bishop say and what was the context of his remarks? Bishop Kalarangta made the controversial remarks while addressing the laity of the occasion of the 8th day of Lent of Mary at a church in Kuravilangad in Kottayam district. While speaking about the importance of protecting families and young women, the bishop raised the twin issues of love jihad and narcotic jihad as grave threats to young men and women of Christian and other non-Muslim faiths. It was the first time a senior Catholic bishop took direct aim at the Muslim community by raising the theory of love and narcotic jihad. He claimed that since weapons cannot be easily used to destroy people of other faiths in a democratic society like India, jihadists are using means which are not easily identifiable. He said that women of non-Muslim faiths were being subjected to exploitation, forced religious conversion, and terrorist activities by jihadi groups after trapping them through love and other means. He cited the examples of Nimisha and Sonia Sebastian, who had converted from Hinduism and Christianity respectively to marry Muslim men and later ended up in ISIS-controlled Afghanistan to fight for the terror group. Subsequently, he spoke of an organized racket through narcotic jihad by which youngsters of non-Muslim faiths were being lured and trapped through drugs. He claimed rampant use of drugs at ice cream parlors, hotels and juice shops run by hardcore jihadis. What kind of political reactions did the bishop's remark elicit? Chief Minister Pinari Vijayan, in his first response to the bishop's remark, said it was the first time he had heard of a term called narcotic jihad. He said that while the context and circumstances of the bishop's remarks were not clear, the issues of narcotic is an anti-social issue and doesn't have any religious use. He added that those responsible positions must refrain from making statements that cause divisions in society. A few days later, at another press conference, the chief minister stressed that the state has no intention of initiating legal proceedings against the bishop, even though it's been labeled as hate speech by many. The CPIM formally echoed the CM's remarks, saying the bishop did not have sinister motives behind making the claim of narcotic jihad. The Congress struck a harder position on the bishop's comment, saying he had crossed the line. Leader of opposition V.D. Sasthisan made a public appeal to all religious and community leaders not to make remarks that would endanger the peace, harmony and trust existing between people in the state. He claimed that while cases of drugs, attacks against women and murders have been increased, it's wrong to pin them to a particular community religion. There was a strong condemnation from the Muslim outfits too. Kanthapuram AP Abu Bakar Musailir, who heads the AP faction of Sunni scholars in the state, said the bishop must take back his remarks. He underlined that Islam does not approve forced religious conversion through deception. Similarly, Syed Jeffrey Mukhtokaya Thangal, president of Samasta Kerala Jamaat Ulama, said if the bishop had evidence of narcotic jihad, he should have given the information to the government instead of making a public statement targeting the Muslim community. Such remarks were unexpected from an influential leader who's expected to foster harmony. The BJP, however, made a fervent defense of the bishop's remarks, saying he had only said what the party and its fountainhead, the RSS, had been saying all along. The party state president K. Surendran said that there are attempts to silence the bishop for speaking the truth. The state unit even wrote to Home Minister Amit Shah seeking security of the Pala bishop and a law to check jihadi activities. What is the fallout of the bishop's comments? Kalarangta's remarks were widely seen by those in the liberal space as vitiating the peace and trust between Christians and Muslims, who together make up 45% of Kerala's demographics. The remarks were seen by many as feigning sentiments of Islamophobia among Christians in the state and be used as a dog whistle to vilify the Muslim community without any valid evidence. The Pallai Dose, however, said in a statement that the bishop never intended to hurt anyone, but was merely issuing a warning about some dangerous trends in the society. It said bishop loved and respected all religions and was only passing on advice to the society to root out evils like drugs. Following the remarks of the Muslim Coordination Committee organized a protest march to the bishop's house, but was stopped by the police. Another march was also carried out by Christian outfits the next day in support of the bishop. The BJP has called for an all-party meeting to discuss issues of love and narcotic jihad and dismissed rumors that the party was trying to foment trouble. The Congress, on the other hand, has been making attempts to initiate discussions between leaders of all communities and religions to restore communal balance in the state. On Monday, September 20, a meeting of an array of religious leaders was convened by Syro Malankar Catholic Church Major Archbishop Basilonus Klimis in Thiruvananthapuram. Thank you.